Welcome to the Vantage HR Influencers Podcast. This podcast is sponsored by Vantage Circle, the leading employee benefits and engagement platform.
Hi everyone, this is Sushmita from Vantage HR Influencer Podcast. Well, today we have with us Dr. Aparna Shetty, who has been conducting wide research in areas of marketing and HR management and its application in the corporate world. Welcome to the show, Aparna.
Thank you so much, Sushmita.
Well, so before we start, we would like to know a little more about your experiences and achievements.
Okay, so I come with 20 years of experience. I worked in manufacturing, service, then shifted to academics. Now I'm completely on my own. Throughout my journey, I worked in two profiles, started with sales marketing, and then worked widely in HR area. And I have my own venture called ProTouch, and we are completely into corporate training solutions.
Okay.
And we give a lot of certifications programs in HR.
Okay.
As far as my diversity and inclusion work starts, you know, what motivated me to work in diversity and inclusion is, personally, being a dark child, I went through a lot of exclusion. I went through a lot of ups and downs emotionally.
Okay.
Second, being a woman, also, many times we came across a lot of inequality. So somewhere I felt, why not to work in this area?
Okay.
So after exploring this area, I also got into prevention of sexual harassment at workplace.
Okay.
So all these things led me to take initiatives for women leadership. And this is what areas I work in. Okay. I have also authored one book called Where to Draw the Line. That's right. So that book is all about the POSH, that is prevention of sexual harassment at workplace. And though I work in the area of women, I truly believe in equality. So that is what is all about me. I hope that helps you.
Okay, yeah. Sure. So coming to the topic, as we navigate the impact of COVID-19, it is important to continue developing a culture of belonging. With several of our staff working remotely, we should concentrate on helping our employees interact and find new ways to emphasize on inclusion. So today we'll be talking about diversity and inclusion while working from home. So let's start with the basic.
Okay.
How would you simply define diversity and inclusion, and what are the factors that it includes?
Okay, so I think after working in this area, I also realized there is one thing which we need to be very focused about, that what these words means to us. Okay, so diversity is all about differences. Diversity about variety. Okay, so for example, people coming from different cultures, different race, age, religion, disability, sexual orientation, right? Gender, that is another and very important part of diversity. So this is all about diversity.
Okay.
But diversity is incomplete without inclusion. Okay. I always say, if you look at company culture, your management, top leadership will get people from various parts. You will have five generations working together. But what is very important part is, are they being respected and appreciated? Are they being included, or there is still exclusion happens at workplace? Because on diversity, company can work, but on inclusion, each and every employee needs to work. And that is where their belief system, their culture, makes a huge difference. So inclusion is, we always say, is a measure of culture that enables diversity to thrive. If inclusion is not there, then diversity has no meaning.
Right. So I'm sure that we can see some clear benefits of diversity and inclusion in employee engagement. Would you like to highlight some?
Sure. Having said that, you know, Sushmita, I fundamentally do not understand this question. What are the benefits? You know, because what I personally feel, why do we need to express or discuss the benefits of diversity.
Right.
First of all, people coming from different walks of life, whether they're black, white, tall, aged, men, women, transgender, right? Everyone has a right to get the job.
Right.
But the thing is this, unfortunate part is this, that now we need to define and discuss the benefits so the people will get convinced about it.
True.
Having said that, now this is the requirement. But there is a huge research, you know, which shows that once you have a diversity at workplace, you may have, you know, higher innovation, different perspectives, you know, faster problem solving. And again, diversity doesn't mean only men, women and all this, but, you know, including people from all levels. Even your office assistant can give you a really wonderful idea.
Right.
There are so many businesses are, losing out the market share just because they have positioned their products in a certain way. So can we come up with, neutral products? Right. The more and more we come up with neutral products, we will have better and better businesses.
Right.
Like, for example, I can give the recent example of Urban Club, okay, which has come up with beauty services even for men. So the moment you include people, companies are going to get. I can give you another example of, you know, Indian company Haldiram's.
Right.
Earlier, they used to have only sweets. And sweets, we are also considering it as unhealthy. But now they are coming up healthy. So if you include people from different tastes, preferences, thoughts, needs, who is going to get benefit? It's only company. So you can see increased profit. When various people work together, you will have lesser attrition. And the best part is, you know, it becomes a company reputation. Like, for example, the younger generation wants to work with diverse workforce. So these are a few benefits which we can see when you have diversity and inclusion at workplace.
Right. So now work from home has become the new norm. Do you think that remote working has narrowed the scope of inclusion at workplace?
See, it is too early to say anything. Having said that, the best part which we get to see, because, you know, diversity and inclusion, Shushmita, we need to also see it has got a highest impact of social culture, which comes to workplace unconsciously, unintentionally, right? Like, for example, in our society, we have always seen, the housework was degraded, was not that respected. So during this lockdown period, people have realized the importance of housework.
True.
The importance of how much effort goes into that. When they started sharing the responsibility, now I'm damn sure when people will come back to workforce, they will understand what challenges of, you know, women, the challenges of young generation. Especially here, I would like to highlight the gender or the sex differences. Getting my point? Like, for example, people also realize the respect. There are many men who expressed that, you know, I could see the respect going down when I'm at home. There is a huge change.
Right.
So sharing responsibility, respecting each and every job, being more empathetic, this behavior you will see post-COVID. So that is my take, right? But again, it has to be a part of our DNA when we work on diversity and inclusion, right? Like I always say, when you are working on in diversity and inclusion, there are three H which you need to work upon. One is heart, you know. Heart is, first of all, you should have that feeling. You should have a compassion. You should feel that, you know, everyone on this planet deserves the equal treatment.
Right.
Second, then to bring equality, what is it that I can do? You need to think. You need to have practices at workplace. And only practices having in your policy book will not help. But now hand, that means, is it getting practiced? or it is only to decorate the shelf. So if you have these three things at workplace, it will be really helpful.
Right. So how can managers or employers foster an inclusive at work, at home workplace? Also, if you can share some of the best D&I activities that most of the top companies are following nowadays.
To my surprise, many companies are still working on diversity and inclusion. Mm-hmm. And honestly speaking, it doesn't matter whether you're working from home or not. Mm-hmm. There are some strata of the society. We have also given a lot of sessions on, sorry to say, and it is a little unfortunate part, but which we need to highlight, mm-hmm. that equal treatment, respect, and not to have domestic violence. Because during this COVID-19, there are two things have come up, gone up drastically. One is domestic violence and second is sexual harassment. Now, many people ask, when women are not coming or when employees are not coming to workplace, how the sexual harassment will take place. Mm. So,
it's still happening in their homes.
There are text messages are going. Mm. There are, you know, video links are sharing. Even the laptop are, you know, company laptops are used. So many companies are conducting a lot of sessions related to this as well. Mm-hmm. Because there is a lot of stress. Okay. Maybe many companies and many people may get surprised with this kind of initiatives, but this is happening. Okay.
So most often we come across sayings like getting all the employees on board with diversity and inclusion initiatives is really difficult. What do you say is the most difficult part of implementing a D&I program? What are your views on it?
There are two things when I look at diversity and inclusion and the challenges. First is commitment of leadership.
Okay.
So when I say commitment of leadership, what do I mean by that? Most importantly, we need to acknowledge that there are challenges. There is an inequality. There is a possibility. Because sometimes, you know, many things happen in a very subtle way, which we do not even realize. Most of the incidences do not happen in front of us. And we feel this is not happening. So first, acknowledge that this happened. Once the acknowledgement happens from top-level management, then it will go till and reach till bottom level, because then you will come up with practices and policies about equality, right? So this is one thing which we need to work upon. Okay. Second very important thing I would like to highlight is the unconscious biases which we carry. All human beings have unconscious biases. We do not even realize that we are getting biased while working. And especially at the time of hiring, promoting, giving job roles, job responsibilities, you know, we assume many things and we make decisions. And those unconscious biases needs to be addressed. Right. Because when you know openly the bias is there, discrimination is there, there are some laws and, you know, policies and everything will work. But there are some unconscious biases. We don't even realize that these things are happening. Getting my point? Like, for example, I will certainly tell you this. Okay, many times people say that, madam, you conduct these sessions and all. Sometimes we feel, you know, there is no gender gap and there is nothing like this. But after conducting these sessions, it is coming to our mind now. Okay, so I always tell them, you know, like when we were, you know, when Britishers were here in India, for us, that was a normal life. But few freedom fighters came forward and said that we are gulam. They created that awareness. Am I right? And that is where we all realized that we need to work for it. Getting my point? Right. So these are some unconscious things are there around, and we need to accept. I always say not only accept but appreciate. These are some blind spots we carry. And that is where we need to be careful about. And there is a lot of neurology also happens in this, right? Like, for example, our brain is also programmed in a certain way psychologically, and we need to work on this. So two challenges. One is leadership, and second is unconscious biases which are there, prevailing in the society and amongst us.
Okay, so we hear a lot about employee benefit programs. Can these programs be of some help in boosting workplace inclusion?
Okay, so there are various programs and various initiatives taken by, there are some mandatory laws are also there, like for example, women director on boards, maternity leave, right? Rights of person with disabilities, LGBT rights. Now, this is what we are talking about, diversity. It is not only about women. It's a bigger picture, okay? So, there are certain things which we are doing it maybe forcibly right now because these things are not there. And when there is a compulsion and a mandate, companies are following. And this is whether you are working from home, whether it is not work from home, during post-COVID, not, you know, in normal situation, this gets applicable. Having said that, I personally do not feel that there are many very specific initiatives only for keeping in mind a particular community or particular gender companies are taking. Like, for example, flexi work hours or work from home, right? Let me tell you, there are so many case studies you will get that always people used to feel that, you know, flexi work timings or work from home activities are required only by women employees. Where you will see this, when these initiatives were taken, many, many men employees or male employees opted for this and many female employees did not opt for this. And this was a very, surprising factor.
Okay.
After conducting the survey, we got to know that many male employees wanted to have work from home. And women says, no, we want to be away from the home for at least for 8 hours. We feel fresh. We feel part of the system. And we focus more. Now, just imagine, Sushmita, there are so many women are also saying, especially right now, my focus is working women. The workload has gone so up because they are looking after house. Because there are still the major part of cooking and kitchen, men are not able to handle.
Right.
Getting my point. And women, like in my team also, many women says that when are we going to start office? So at least I can lock the house and can be away from house for 8 hours.
Right.
My duties are not taking over.
Mm-hmm.
So this is another unconscious bias I'm saying, that we think that there are some people needs particular thing and some people don't need it.
Mm-hmm.
I will tell you another, daycare facilities. We always think that daycare facilities are required for women employees. Who said? Flexi work timing. See, please understand, it's the nature of the work. It is not about sex and gender. How is my job? Like, for example, my job requires me to be at my desk in the office. I need to go, whether I'm a male or I'm a female, right? Like, for example, earlier we used to have, maternity leaves only for women. Who says that father doesn't want to enjoy his movement in his life?
Right.
He also want to enjoy. And then we came up with paternity leave, right? And now I was talking to a few HR heads in between. And I realized they're saying that, now paternity leave, they are also giving till 3 years. Like, for example, if paternity leaves are, for example, for male employees, we are giving 20 days. Male employees can use it over 3 years of time.
Okay.
Because it's not like that the need is there only at the beginning of the, delivery. Are you getting my point? So we have to see, we just cannot follow certain things what Western world is doing. We have to see the social impact. Like, for example, at the time of delivery, a lady has, she has many hands to help her. But after 3 months, she may need someone's help.
Right.
So Western models we cannot follow. And we have to get over the benefits only for men and women. There are some biologically differences, and for that specific benefits needs to be given. But race needs to be equal. Your daycare facilities, your other benefits, compensation and benefit, your benefits from work from home, flexi, timings, everything has to be equal.
Right.
That is what is my take on this.
So, what is your biggest piece of advice for getting started with D&I?
Amazing. I think my take on diversity and inclusion is currently we are working on it on three ways. One way is mandatory.
Hmm.
You know, legally we have a compulsion to have inclusion, have women employees, have LGBT rights, have disabilities. Because if you don't do it, if you don't follow it, then there will be consequences. And hence we are doing it. Second thing is this, many people are doing it for branding purpose. Like, for example, if I bought a person from LGBT community, people are showing them like a trophy. Let's see,
right.
We are doing all this. Okay.
Hmm.
So people think that I can get brand, I can get profit, I can get business visibility, and that's why hence they are doing. I personally feel we need to work on most important thing is called social accountability,
hmm.
individual accountability, that it has to come from your heart that I want to work. And everyone on this earth deserves the equal right. Mm. Just because someone is from one community, which society has decided weaker section of the society. Opportunity, while giving opportunities, while giving respect, recognition, that community cannot suffer.
Right.
And if we are doing it, it's the biggest mistake which we are doing it. Right? Because if you do mandatory, then there will be hatred, you know, because XYZ got a job because XYZ is a woman. That will create a hatred. So very important is doing it from your heart. Take this as a, your individual accountability. So that will be my take.
Yeah.
And I think one more thing I would like to add in this, that when we are talking about equality, let's talk about equality on equal terms. What do I mean by that? Somewhere in urban areas, we get to see now diversity and inclusion is only about women. It has to go beyond that. It has to go beyond that. So that is also very important, right?
Yeah.
When we are talking about equality, men and women equal. Otherwise, there is a, you know, there will be another campaign after a few years down the line. And what is that campaign? Beta bachao, beta padhao. We do not want to get into that. So let's set the things right now. Let's not hate men. All men are not rapists, right? And we cannot be, you know, that is what we are talking about in the equality in real sense.
Right. So there's a lot more to learn and understand to reap the best benefits of D&I in businesses. Please share the best way our people can reach out to you for more.
Okay, so my name is Dr. Aparna Sethi. You can search me on Google directly on Dr. Aparna Sethi. You will get all the details about me. You can contact me on LinkedIn, right? My company address is, website address is www.protouchpro.com, and they can also get in touch with me there.
Okay, it was a great session with you, Aparna. We hope to meet you again. Thanks a lot for joining.
Thank you so much, Shashmita. Thank you so much for the opportunity. Thanks a lot.
Thanks for listening to Vantage HR Influencers Podcast. Please do subscribe to Vantage HR Influencers Podcast on Apple Podcasts and Spotify for new episodes.